Item three, discussion of possible action on memorandum of agreement with Franklin County, says EMS, but it should be Franklin County Emergency Management Operations Center, as to use of city property. And Mr. Millender, Commissioner Millender and I attended the county meeting on Friday where they declared a state of emergency. And I'm just going to give you a brief briefing here, very brief on what they discussed. It won't be everything. All of it doesn't pertain to us and the housing here, of warehousing inventory. But the county is focusing on providing temporary housing to FEMA park models. I talked to Mike Verone later that day on the phone. He's expecting the first units within the next 2 weeks. And he expects to have most all the units that are needed, that are required to get families in some type of undercover home type situation within the next 60-day timeframe. The county commission passed an ordinance to allow these FEMA units for up to 2 years because they say permanent housing is $1 million away. Permanent housing will run around $80,000 each because they're going to require mobile homes that are built to zone 3 or stick-built homes that are built to code. So they're going to allow these FEMA units in that area for up to 2 years. So that's really long-term temporary to me, anyway. And they're working on a CDBG grant to help purchase some housing, and the Sheriff's Department has dedicated all of their collections to purchasing housing, full-time housing, big, you know, regular homes. So the items, and Ms. Tamara has reported that they're already shipping out items, but the items that are being warehoused here at City Hall, really according to that report, should start being distributed to the recipients of the FEMA units within a couple of weeks, as soon as they start arriving. Mr. Marone told me these FEMA units will not have furniture, so the families are definitely going to need the furniture and the beds that Ms. Tamara's talked about, and certainly household items. And all of the folks in the county know we're here to help, and we're anxious to help with the recovery. They know also that these items have been brought to a, I'm just going to say it outright, a rodent infested building, and it's slated for decommissioning and demolition. So, you know, it's not too long, you know, the time frame needs to be designated. So I feel, you know, we have agreements. In fact, tomorrow I'm signing a memorandum of agreement regarding the agreement that we have with the county for our permitting procedures that we're going to take on. So it's important to have this agreement. You know, this includes all the specifics, and the county attorney and the county coordinator are aware, and they agreed to it. And I think, I know you all have been circulated on an agreement, and we need to get something in place since they're only on the... Okay, that's very good. So we have a, and have you had an opportunity to review, Mr. Taylor has sent a letter. So we have a motion by Commissioner Allen to take the memorandum of agreement, second by Commissioner Mathis. Okay, is there discussion?
So we need an interlocal agreement.
It can't hurt to do a memorandum of agreement with County ESO.
That's what we're talking about.
Yeah, and we're not, I mean, what I think Mr. Allen's talking about too is I don't think we want to, well, it'd be up to the commission whether we want to actually form an interlocal agreement, a whole bunch of requirements that are associated with that. We just want to enter into a memorandum of agreement that's quite sufficient for this. Okay. It's not as much rigmarole that you have with an interlocal.
Any comment on that? I would say I don't think an interlocal agreement is necessary this time since it's a temporary situation. My comment. also, I would like to ask that all of the, and actually it's in the agreement, all of the dog pet food and any food items like crackers and cereal, rice and pasta. And I talked to Mr. Marone about that yesterday, because we have rodents pretty good here. And he said that the county animal control, humane society, that they can take that dog food like right now. And, you know, we're getting, you know, we brought 50 pounds today because it smells so strong and good and, you know, we just, you know, we don't need to add fuel to the fire. And food items. I beg your pardon?
I've been following the rules.
Okay, and then also the food pantries in the target zone, affected zone, can take the boxes of crackers and cereals that they can get into the picnic table and take those. So do we have any other comments?
And what is the motion?
Oh, the motion, Commissioner Allen, motion to accept this memorandum of agreement and send it on over to the county. Commissioner Mathis, second floor.
We just need to have some clear direction on what we're doing. This is a wonderful thing to support people in need, but we have to have some kind of orderly direction.